Evacuations continuing in areas near Taal Volcano following Thursday's eruption. For more on the situation in Batangas, we are now joined on the line by Governor Hermilando Mandanas. Good morning, Governor. Thank you so much for taking our call.
Thank you too, Michelle.
Governor, how's the situation on the ground? What's the sense you're getting from the residents there? Have you started evacuating residents? What's happening?
Well, as everybody knows, the eruption, it was really mild. It occurred yesterday at around 3:16. It was only a five-minute physical show, if you want to put it that way. But we have to be very vigilant. It stopped at around 3:21. But nevertheless, during the night, there were the tremors, and there were short bursts still. And our evacuation started, almost immediately. Fortunately, we have been preparing for this because we were on alert level number 2 since several months ago, 6 months ago. So we have been preparing for this together with the other LGUs. There are 14 LGUs that are within the area of concern. But the one that really would be like a permanent danger zone is the volcano island itself. Well, we cleared that last April. So nobody has been there anymore with the help of the uniformed people. And we had transferred them somewhere. Now the evacuation has been going on, since yesterday afternoon, with the help of, coordination from the provincial disaster risk and the municipal and city disaster risk. So we have been providing family homes, food for them, and food going on. I just finished a meeting with Secretary Rolly Bautista of the Department of Social Welfare, who has always been on the ball. The last time it erupted, we were together, and he was all drenched with, this water and sulfur dust. And so now it's really the smoke, the sulfuric plume, as they call it, coming from the magma going up, met by the water inside the volcano, the lake within the volcano. So,
Governor,
we evaluated, and so we're prepared. Except now, we have to request for more test kits. And, of course, more masks and more vaccine. Because with the number of evacuees, which we have right now, and they go not only in the 14, because they go all over Batangas. One big help in the evacuation effort would really be their relatives. So they are in Batangas City, Lipa, as far as Nasugbuta. Yeah. So we have to support them. So the plume actually went towards the southwest. Well, it's an area where, from an economic point of view, it's not as important as the other part. It is very important. But it's more affected would be really the population. The population. For example, as you know, Batangas is the most powerful province. We supply the equivalent of more than the requirement of electric power of the whole Metro Manila and Calabarzon. So you could imagine that no damage, no smoke, no dust going to that side of Batangas. And the same way, when it comes to our tourism, is still not reached by all of this. Our petrochemical plant, the only one operating in the whole country, also in Batangas City, not affected. So
okay, that's good to know, sir.
The expansions are all going on. So from an economic point of view, I know that your audience are very concerned about the effect of the volcano on the economic situation. So we continue. Good. We are now going to the construction of our port is there. Going on, not affected at all. Mm-hmm. And likewise, our food terminal. You know that Batangas has been named as the gateway by the Department of Agriculture of the agri-industrial business corridor. That's why now it's the site. There is a with a loan from Korea putting up livestock. You know, the Batangas is famous for our beef, and we supply a lot of pork to Metro Manila, in spite of the Asian or the African swine fever. So it's on, not affected at all. Our energy hub, wherein there will be more power plants and the liquefied petroleum gas project to supply fuel, cleaner fuel than the coal fed. So all of these things are going on. Our port,
that's good to know, sir.
The Batangas International Port, which is
business as usual.
Biggest number of passengers, three times bigger than the Port of Manila, is not affected at all. So
that's
from an economic point of view,
yes, sir.
Not much effect. Of course, there has been a delay in the expansion of Steel Asia, and they are in Lemery. They're expanding. They're really now in Calaca. And when this is finished, Steel Asia, Batangas, will be the biggest producer of steel, especially for rebars for construction.
Okay.
So the economy of Batangas continues. And we are praying that this volcanic eruption, which has been mild, we went only to level 3, of course. The highest level will be level 5, and that will be really full blast. The last time, we reached only level 4. That was 4. Mm-hmm. Nobody died. The damage was really contained, unlike the one in 1965, where several died.
Governor, and damage.
Yes, Michelle.
Governor Mandanas, thank you so much for sharing the updates. Unfortunately, we don't have much time, but we will definitely have to invite you back again because I wanted to discuss the Mandanas ruling as well and the impact on how it empowers, you know, local governments to better handle crisis like this. Sir, thank you so much. We hope that
I know we don't have time now, but that the ruling of the Supreme Court on the full devolution, there is actually no reduction in budget. It's just now it's going to be level up from the countryside.
We will be having you back. We'll definitely have you back to talk about that, sir. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll be closely following developments from Batangas. Thank you, sir.
And thank you too, Michelle.